Hi, I'm Aisha. You are watching Educational Hub. The discussion chapter is where you delve into the meaning, importance and relevance of your results. It should focus on explaining and evaluating what you found, showing how it relates to your literature review and research questions, and making an argument in support of your overall conclusion. So today we discuss about discussion section in research paper. There are many different ways to write this section, but you can focus your discussion around four key elements. Interpretations. What do the results mean? Implications. Why do the results matter? Limitations. What can't the results tell us? Recommendations. What practical actions or scientific studies should follow?
What is discussion in research paper? The purpose of the discussion is to interpret and describe the significance of your findings in light of what was already known about the research problem being investigated and to explain any new understanding or insights that emerged as a result of your study of the problem.
How to write discussion section in research paper. Step 1. Summarize your key findings. Start this chapter by reiterating your research problem and concisely summarizing your major findings. Don't just repeat all the data you have already reported. Aim for a clear statement of the overall result that directly answers your main research question. This should be no more than one paragraph. For example, examples: the results indicate that the study demonstrates a correlation between this analysis supports the theory that the data suggests that. Step 2. Give your interpretations. The meaning of the results might seem obvious to you, but it's important to spell out their significance for the reader and show exactly how they answer your research questions. The form of your interpretations will depend on the type of research, but some typical approaches to interpreting the data include identifying correlations, patterns, and relationships among the data, discussing whether the results met your expectations or supported your hypotheses, contextualizing your findings within previous research and theory, explaining unexpected results and evaluating their significance, considering possible alternative explanations and making an argument for your position. You can organize your discussion around key themes, hypotheses, or research questions. Following the same structure as your results section, you can also begin by highlighting the most significant or unexpected results.
You can organize your discussion around key themes, hypotheses, or research questions, following the same structure as your results section. You can also begin by highlighting the most significant or unexpected results. For example, in line with the hypothesis, contrary to the hypothesized association, the results contradict the claims of Smith, 2007, that the results might suggest that X. However, based on the findings of similar studies, a more plausible explanation is Y. Step 3. Discuss the implications. As well as giving your own interpretations, make sure to relate your results back to the scholarly work that you surveyed in the literature review. The discussion should show how your findings fit with existing knowledge, what new insights they contribute, and what consequences they have for theory or practice. Ask yourself these questions. Do your results agree with previous research? If so, what did they add to it? Are your findings very different from other studies? If so, why might this be? Do the results support or challenge existing theories? Are there any practical implications? Your overall aim is to show the reader exactly what your research has contributed and why they should care. For example, these results build on existing evidence of the results do not fit with the theory that the experiment provides a new insight into the relationship between. These results should be taken into account when considering how to. The data contributes a clearer understanding of. While previous research has focused on X, these results demonstrate that Y.
Step 4. Acknowledge the limitations. Even the best research has some limitations, and acknowledging these is important to demonstrate your credibility. Limitations aren't about listing your errors, but about providing an accurate picture of what can and cannot be concluded from your study. Limitations might be due to your overall research design, specific methodological choices, or unanticipated obstacles that emerged during the research process. You should only mention limitations that are directly relevant to your research objectives, and evaluate how much impact they had on achieving the aims of the research.
For example, if your sample size was small or limited to a specific group of people, note that this limits its generalizability. If you encountered problems when gathering or analyzing data, Explain how these influence the results. If there are potential confounding variables that you were unable to control, acknowledge the effect these may have had. After noting the limitations, you can reiterate why the results are nonetheless valid for the purpose of answering your research questions. For example, the generalizability of the results is limited by the reliability of this data is impacted by due to the lack of data on X, the results cannot confirm. The methodological choices were constrained by it is beyond the scope of this study to. Step 5. State your recommendations. Based on the discussion of your results, you can make recommendations for practical implementation or further research. Sometimes the recommendations are saved for the conclusion. Suggestions for further research can lead directly from the limitations. Don't just state that more studies should be done. Give concrete ideas for how future work can build on areas that your own research was unable to address. Further research is needed to establish. Future studies should take into account.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.